In this video, we will revisit the nature and nurture discussion. As I mentioned in an earlier video, it is, in my opinion, that you can do a lot of things, also with game-bred dogs, the gladiator types, which are, in my opinion, completely not stupid or dysfunctional, but it would be very unwise to neglect the nature part, so the genetics, because these breeds, especially the performance versions thereof, have been bred for centuries for gladiator type of roles. And if you then are able as a pro or a very dedicated person to separate them, for example, of course you can keep them together. Or if you have a hunting dog that is very eager to get its quarry, of course there might be exception to the rule that you can keep them together with their quarry. But is it wise? So in my opinion, you should not only focus on nurture, what you can do with training, but also focus on nature. That being said, I also want to elaborate a little bit more, because it will also frustrate a dog to an enormous extent to go against its natural behavior. Even if you're able to do it, it can be very frustrating for the dog and also for yourself. Because there is a reason, for example, that if you want a shepherd type of dog, you get a totally different type of shepherd dog with an Australian cattle dog, which is there for managing unwilling, harsh, semi-feral cattle, versus the staring method that especially the border collie applies for sheep. And those are still both cattle dogs. So if you're wanting an Australian cattle dog to behave like a border collie or the other way around, you will be hard pressed and also frustrate yourself and the dog, and also endanger them, because they just don't have the package as much. If you would ask a modern day performance bred shepherd that's there for protection work or tactical work, military police, to do the same work a border collie does, also you will be frustrating yourself and the dog to no extent. I'm not saying that you could not teach them a lot, sure you can, but you go against nature. And that's not a good thing, in my opinion, to do. And also, there's such a variety of dogs. Why wouldn't you pick a dog that's far closer to what you really want? The exterior is only one part, it's also about the behavior that you can get out of them. So these were some additional thoughts. Hope they are helpful. The dog on the leash is a Pattadale Terrier, an Earth Terrier specialist. For example, bred to hunt and oftentimes also kill, especially foxes, but also badgers. And I would not recommend if you keep dead foxes together with them. Even if they are of the polar fox variety, they also hunt in different regions, raccoons, raccoon dogs, nutria, even hawk. And therefore, it will be quite unwise, especially to keep them with other predators. And if you're doing it, please separate them when you're gone. But it's a question why you should do it. I also mentioned, if you are keeping rabbits, why would you also keep hunting ferrets that are there to hunt rabbits? I would really advise against it. And now, I was guilty as well. My parents still had some rabbits, and also we got some ferrets. And I told them, don't keep them close to the rabbits, but they did, because in the garden it was the most natural place, easiest place. But even if they cannot get to each other, it can produce stress. And that's something that I would not recommend. My parents said, yeah, they could also keep away rodents, etc. And of course they can. And they will by their smell. Alone already. But I think it's not wise. Because also if rabbits just smell those ferrets, they no longer hear them or see them, it can introduce quite a lot of stress. And also the other way around, because the ferret wants to get to the rabbits. Have a great day.